YouTube. This is the part two of a continuing series about cigars. In my first video, I talked a little bit about the anatomy of a cigar and how they're different than a machine-made cigar. So keep in mind that in my videos I'm talking about premium handmade cigars, much like this Fuente Opus X. This is not a cheap cigar, and sometimes these can be kind of hard to find. And if you're going to spend your money on this type of cigar, you're going to want a way to protect it, to store it, to keep it from drying out. And that's where humidors come into play. And that's what we're going to talk about in this video. Let me adjust the focus. Now, the ideal humidity for storing a cigar is about 68 to 72%. And this is the moisture in the air that keeps the tobacco from drying out. And let's talk a little bit about the different types of humidors. In essence, there are five classifications of humidors. There's the room humidor, which is commonly seen in cigar bars and cigar stores. It's an entire room maintained at the correct humidity for storing large cigar inventories. Then there's the cabinet humidor. The cabinet humidors are freestanding and are used pretty much as a piece of furniture. They typically hold up to a few thousand cigars. Next comes the table humidor. And this is the type of humidor that I use. And they're usually rather heavy and are normally kept in one location. And they're, you know, they're perfect for storing a few hundred, maybe up to a couple thousand cigars. It just depends on what size you have. And after the table humidor, there's the personal humidor. And these are pretty much like a table humidor, except on a much smaller scale. And they usually store between 20 to 100 cigars. A lot of people call them desktop humidors. And I've got two or three of them here. This is one. And this is one also, even though I keep pipe tobacco and pipes in here now. And this one is my main humidor. It's a table humidor. And this one is, I guess you could call it a desktop size humidor. And the last classification would be the travel humidor. It's very portable. And they make it so that you can transport cigars you know, enough for an outing or a trip or some event. The usual capacity on this type is maybe up to 10 or maybe 15 cigars. Now the one I'm going to show you in this video is a tabletop humidor, and it's kind of large, and so let me readjust the camera before we continue. Okay, I'm back. This is my tabletop humidor. I don't really know the capacity. All I can tell you is that it's plenty big. It measures, it's about 16 inches wide, about a foot deep, 8 inches tall. When you go shopping for a humidor, be sure you purchase quality over price. Look for some good hinges. Humidors can be made out of pretty much any type of wood. I prefer mahogany because of its stableness under most conditions. That makes it far less likely to warp. And also a good humidor is going to be made out of, the liner, which is the inside walls in the bottom, inside but the floor and the ceiling. It's going to be made out of Spanish cedar. Spanish cedar has an ability to absorb moisture, and the tobacco beetles don't like the taste of it, so that makes it less likely that you'll have a tobacco beetle infestation inside your humidor. very important, and I can't stress just how important a good seal on a humidor is. And this lip, you can kind of see that. That's a design feature that creates just the right kind of seal when you close the lid. You can check the seal of a humidor before you buy it, simply by opening the lid a couple of inches and then dropping it. You notice that you do not hear wood against wood. You hear kind of a whoosh, and that's caused by a layer of air that is trapped between the lid and the box. That's the sound that you're looking for. Once again, that's not wood against wood, you know, a loud bang. That's kind of a whoosh. Another thing that can cause a humidor not to have a good seal would be low quality hinges, which these are not, or poorly built joints that aren't in alignment. the Spanish cedar lining is that it tends to give the cigars kind of a spicy flavor, and that's appreciated by a lot of the cigar smokers. You would never use any other kind of cedar. It has to be Spanish cedar. Any other kind of cedar would make your cigars just taste terrible. Now when you get your new humidor, you have to, you want to season it before you put your cigars in. And basically what seasoning is just introducing moisture back into the Spanish cedar. And there's two ways of doing that. If you're in a hurry, you can just take a sponge that's been dampened with some distilled water. You have to use distilled water. You don't want the minerals and stuff that tap water has in it, so be sure to use distilled water. You can take the damp sponge and just wipe down the inside of the humidor, including any trays that your humidor might have. But that's not the way I like to do it. I just like to take a shallow bowl and fill it with distilled water, place it in the bottom of the humidor, and put a sponge in there with it, and just close it up and let it sit for a couple of days. After that, you can take the dish out, take the sponge out, and fill the humidor up, and you're set to go. You can keep an eye on the humidity just using a hygrometer, and they can be digital or they can be analog. This one's digital, and whenever the humidity drops into the low 60s, you can just take a mixture of distilled water and glycol and saturate your humidification device with it. And I think I got a minute or two. I'll show you how to do that. Okay. This is a 50-50 solution of propylene glycol and distilled water. We just call it 50-50. You can mix it yourself if you buy the propylene glycol, or you can just buy a little bottle that's pre-mixed like this. Just open up the top. It in there. Just saturate it. Now this one is in good shape, so it's not going to hold very much. Before you put it back in the humidor, be sure to turn it upside down. Maybe shake on it, shake it out a little bit, because you don't want it to drip. You don't want it to drip on top of your, all over your cigars. It's just a magnetic, just magnets to hold it on. This is another type of device. Looks like it could use a charge. This one's actually kind of dry. I'm going to let this one sit for a little bit. But anyway, that's You know, there's probably a lot of things I left out of this video, but I just don't have time in 15 minutes to say everything I want to say. So, that's all for now.